back in December. That's my picture that Washington Post took 8 years ago when Chuck Brown died dancing in front of the Howard Theater. And they put it in the museum, the historical museum. I also made the Washington Post June the 16th when George Floyd got killed. They had the peaceful rally in Washington, D.C. with the GoGo bands of Houston. It was my article and my photo shoot that made the Washington Post, which I have a copy of that. I've won many hand dance contests in this town. The only trans who ever won a hand dance contest in history. I've also performed at the Lincoln Theater and seen this pageant from females, the first one, the only one that ever did that. Whether I won or not, that wasn't the point. I was a winner when I was nominated because it's never been done. I performed at places like the Eclipse. I performed in Ocean City one time. I opened up for EU. I've had brilliant shows. I've had one at the National Zoo in Washington, D.C., which Patty Deacon heard about that because Bobby was gone because she was in the show. I performed at the North Dinner, like I said, the Mission City. I'm here now at the legendary Chateau where it's a straight club. I'm the first and only transgender to ever start having shows over in this club as well as others right here where you're taking this video at, because they've never had drag shows or the type of shows that I can present to them, but the owner that allowed me a chance to express myself, so I made history in that too.
How'd you learn how to hand dance?
My mother taught me.
You're a great hand dancer.
Thank you.
No lessons at all, right?
Never no lessons. No, they didn't have them. I told you, I'm 65. I'll be 66 this year. We did it by doorknobs, rooms, you know, stuff like that. There's no classes back then. Either you got it or you don't have it.
What do you love about the Chateau?
I love dancing, period. I have family over here, extended family. It's historic to me. It's legendary. I've been coming here for decades. It's still standing, and I'm still standing, and I'm still loyal to the Chateau, regardless of the owner.
How did you
name
Pupu? Where did that come from?
My mother named me Pupu. Every name my mother gave me, I use it today. I made up a name.
So you are what they call it, part of history in Washington, D.C. You're somebody who is historical.
I am historical. Once you're in the Afro-American Museum, that's history automatically. If you go down on the fourth floor, over top of Chuck Brown's exhibit, across from James Brown and Whitney Houston's exhibit, you'll see me in the circle up by the Howard dancing.
Fantastic. Tell me, what does Pupu know for sure?
That I'm a winner. I'm number one. I'm historian and I'm immortal. That's what I know for sure. I'm immortal. I'll never be forgotten. There was never none before me. There could never be none after I'm gone.
Who was the three people that influenced you most of your life?
God, my mother, the legendary icon.
Mind. I'm gonna take me to do some of the